Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Here we have Qisas al-Nabiyyin by Abu al-Hasan al-Nadwi. And he calls it Qisas al-Nabiyyin, which is the plural of prophets, to differentiate between the famous Ibn Kathir's Qisas al-Anbiya. Okay, it's a different way to make it plural. So the word Nabi can be made plural by saying Nabiyyin, and it can be made plural by saying Anbiya, which is a broken plural. A broken plural is anything that you disrupt the root in itself, and you don't simply add waw noon or ya noon. So I think the best way to learn Arabic, right? And when we talk about Arabic, we're talking about reading classical texts, not talking about speaking. We're talking about reading classical texts. That's what's important. That's where our deen is, and that's where there's great value. Is to constantly read. We're also going to look at some grammar. This is not a formal grammar course, but we will look at some grammar here. So Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim here is written in what's called the Ruk'ah script, okay, which is the simple hand script that was developed in the Abbasid times for quick note taking. All right, and then the rest of it is in what's called Naskh, which is the script that is very crisp and clear, and that is the script that you see in the Quran. All right, Men kassara al-asnam. Who broke the idols? Men who kassara, all right, broke al-asnam, the idols. Okay, asnam here is what we call a broken plural. Why? Because the root of the word is sanam, sad, noon, mim. Okay, so sanam. So asnam is the plural of sanam. And it's a broken plural because you're sticking in alif here and you're sticking in alif here, so you've broken up the word. Okay, we call that in Arabic jama' taksir, broken plural. Ba'i'ul asnam, the seller of idols. Okay, bay'a, all right, is the word for sales, and ba'a is the one who sells. Qabla ayyamin kathiratin kathiratin jiddan. This is not a period, this is just something in the copy. Okay, qabla ayyamin kathiratin. Okay, kathiratin jiddan. Okay, or maybe he did put a period here, I don't know. Wouldn't make sense. All the other periods are smaller, so it does make sense to think that this is just a mistake. This means qabla, means before, ayyamin, days. And then in Arabic, we put the adjective of a word after the noun. So we say kathiratin to describe ayyam, many. Okay, before many, many days. Okay, like a story, starting a story a long, long time ago. Okay, jiddan is a description of a description. Okay, so jiddan, much. All right. Kana fi qaryatin rajulun mashhurun jiddan. And notice he's going to try to use the same words a lot. Kana, there was. Fi qaryatin, this is what we call jar wa majrur, or prepositional phrase. And the prepositions are min, wa illa, wa an, wa ala, wa fi, wal kaf, wal ba, wal lam. Okay. Kana was fi qaryatin, in a village. A qarya is a village. Okay. Rajulun mashhurun jiddan. Okay, so this is, if you want a little bit of advanced type of grammar, the mubtada mu'akhar. Okay, rajulun mashhurun jiddan, a man who is very famous. Again, the adjective after the noun. Jiddan, much. Wa kana ismu hadha ar-rajuli azara. Again, he uses the word kana. Was. Again, the sentence structure is very different. So this sentence means, and the name of this man was Azar. But we put the verb first in Arabic. Okay, was the name of this man Azar. Okay. وَكَانَ أَزَرُ يَبِيعُ الْأَصْنَامَ. And Azar used to sell idols. يَبِيع is a regular verb. Okay. And verbs are of three types: command, past, and present/future. Okay, and the sign of a indicator of a present/future verb is the word anaitu. Anaitu is combined of four letters: alif, nun, ya, and ta. And usually, you will find that at the beginning of the verb in the construction of the verb. So this is ya. Yabi'u means he sells. So you're always going to have a dhamma on such a verb. We call this al-fi'l al-mudari'. Okay? Al-fi'l al-mudari'. Alright. Al-asnama is the maf'ul bihi. This is what he used to sell. So what we call the object of the sentence. And the object of the sentence is what we call mansub, and you always put a fatha on what is mansub. Okay? We will do official grammar sessions, don't worry about that, but pick up what you can now as we do this. وَكَانَ فِي هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةِ بَيْتٌ كَبِيرٌ جِدًّا. And there was, again, كَانَ, there was. فِي هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةِ. This is again, جَارُ وَمَجْرُورُ. Okay, prepositional phrase. The حروف الجر, مِنْ وَإِلَّا وَعَنْ وَعَلَى وَفِي وَرُبْ وَالْكَافُ وَالْبَاءُ وَاللَّمْ. فِي هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةِ. Anytime you get مِنْ وَإِلَّا وَعَنْ وَعَلَى وَفِي وَرُبْ وَالْبَاءُ وَالْكَافُ وَاللَّمْ, the words after it will take khafd, which means kasra. Fi hadhihi al-qaryati, in this village. So what was there? Baytun kabirun jiddan. Okay, there was a house, big, very. Exact, pretty much opposite order of how we speak in English. So we would have said a very big house, right? Exact opposite. But in Arabic, we're going to put the noun first, or the ism first, and then the adjective, and then the description of the adjective. Okay, baytun kabirun. How big was it? Jiddan. So jiddan describes kabir, and kabir describes bayt. وَكَانَ فِي هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. Again, فِي هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. هَذَا is the masculine of هَذِهِ. Okay, if you notice here, you have فِي and فِي, هَذِهِ and هَذَا, الْقَرْيَةِ and الْبَيْتِ. What's the difference? The difference is الْقَرْيَةِ ends with this ta marbuta, therefore it is a indicates to us that it's feminine. This al-qarya, it has a ta marbuta which indicates to us that it's feminine. But this bayt, this word al-bayt, the house, does not have a ta marbuta, so it's masculine. So fi hadha al-bayti. So they're both prepositional phrases, or we call jar wa majrur. Okay? And hadha and hadhihi do not impact the grammar, it's just saying this. Okay? So hadhihi is this feminine and hadha is this masculine. وَكَانَ فِي هَذَا الْبَيْتِ أَصْنَامٌ. Okay. In this house there was what? Idols. أَصْنَامٌ كَثِيرَةٌ جِدًّا. Again, he's trying to repeat words. Idols, many, very. Okay. So, just like we said, بَيْتٌ كَبِيرٌ جِدًّا, here he says, أَصْنَامٌ كَثِيرَةٌ جِدًّا. أَصْنَام is a non-human plural. The non-human plural is always treated as feminine. So that's why here you have kabir, masculine, but here you have kathira. You see that tamarbuta right there? Okay, oops. This tamarbuta right here indicates to us that it's feminine. Okay, and the word jiddan, okay, which describes how, okay, is how much it is, does not have masculine or feminine. Okay. وَكَانَ فِي هَذَا الْبَيْتِ أَصْنَامٌ أَصْنَامٌ كَثِيرَةٌ جِدًّا. وَكَانَ النَّاسُ يَسْجُدُونَ لِهَذِهِ الْأَصْنَامِ. And the people, كَانَ, again, was. The people were used to, or the people were. النَّاسُ is the people. Right? What did they used to do? يَسْجُدُونَ, they used to prostrate. لِهَذِهِ الْأَصْنَامِ. Here we have this same word here. هَذِهِ. Okay? But we have it here. And what's this? This is لِ. The لِ, which means to. And again, that's a prepositional phrase. Okay, as we said, min wa ila wa an wa ala wa fi wa rub wal kaf wal ba wal lam. This lam here means to. Okay, so li hadhihi al asnami, to these idols. Okay, and so that's why we put the kasra. Wa kana nasu yasjuduna li hadhihi al asnami. Wa kana azaru, again was. This is the verb, helping verb was. Azaru يَسْجُدُ لِهَذِهِ الْأَصْنَامِ. آزَرُ used to prostrate. يَسْجُدُ لِهَذِهِ الْأَصْنَامِ. وَكَانَ آزَرُ يَسْجُدُ لِهَذِهِ الْأَصْنَامِ. آزَرُ used to prostrate to these idols. Again, وَكَانَ آزَرُ, آزَرُ used to, يَعْبُدُ هَذِهِ الْأَصْنَامَ, and who used to worship these idols. Now you notice, what's the difference between this أَصْنَام and this أَصْنَام? This has a fatha and this has a kasra. Why? Because this one is part of a clause, a prepositional phrase, which we call jar wa majrur, which is to these idols. Whereas this here is not. This is the object of the verb. What verb? Ya'budu. Wa kana azaru ya'budu al-asnama. And as I said earlier, this word hadha and hadhihi have no effect on the grammar. So you just stick them in wherever and they'll fit. So here they're part of a clause, here they're part of a regular sentence. So ya'budu, worship, again, is fi'al mudara with a dhamma. Ya'budu hadhihi al-asnama. Because when you have a object of a sentence, object of the verb, it just gets a fatha. All right, so that's the end of your first lesson in reading. And this section here consists of 21 pages. The story of Ibrahim is 21 pages, and we finished basically one and a half.